واحد
and zero
صفر
صفر good so you can write your numbers like your phone number in Arabic okay can I call anyone who is ready to write the number we need 10 digit phone number come over here and write down on the board
I'll just come
back. Okay. Usually when you are writing with your hand, so use handwritten style, yes. Okay. Now you made it print version.
Sorry.
Okay, that's fine. Same number write down again with handwritten. This also not handwritten.
Yeah, this is print, right?
Yes, yes.
This will be right. I'm confused with that now. That
So you want to write the script, handwritten, right? So it's not handwritten, it's printed.
So this would be like
yes, very good. Now read the number in Arabic, all these 10.
I can, one by one number.
Yes, one by one.
Not like the
Saba.
This is not the Arabic style, right?
Yeah.
What is the thing that is not making it Arabic style?
No hyphens.
Yes, the hyphen. There is no hyphens or gap between the numbers.
It's very westernized.
Yes, that's right. Okay. Brother Norman. Come over here. Write down a date of birth.
Oh,
that's so hard.
Let me write
the real one. Date of birth. Wow.
January 1st, 1981. Okay. But can you write with two digits? Because we would like to know that you are writing in Arabic style. Now read in Arabic.
It's
Salasa, Arba, Hamsa, Wahid, Tisa, Sabah, and
Sifa. So what is this stand for? What does it? Yeah, this is this
day.
Day. Why did you bring day first?
Because Arabic.
In Arabic, yes. Mm, we bring the day first. Then
month.
Hamsa is the month, and then the year. Very good. Good job. Okay. So everyone now is very good in numbers, Arabic numbers. You can write down. You can. And also, in date of birth, you are allowed to make the slash. Okay? So it's okay in while you are writing date of birth.
And like, super and then well, I mean the slope, pi or Hamsa, super Hamsa, that's like this, like in English, it's like 01, 01, 19, 01.
Oh, like over here?
Yeah. Making it two digits?
Yes, but you can do that. Is it allowed? Okay.
So, for normal Arabic, you should use the other way. Yamam, DD, YYY.
Yes, in Arabic, DD.
Not the Western form.
No, not the Western
form. Normal format.
Normal.
So you put month first, slash,
day first. No, day is first.
Day first, month. And then,
the year, yes.
So it should be the
exactly.
Oh.
DD, MM, then YYY. It's, I think, British style.
Yeah.
Okay, so. Al-an iftahu kitabakum. Nahnu al-yawm indana. Safha raqam. 79. 79. It talks about the letters Dal, Dal, Ra, and Za. So I remember that last Sunday we completed Dal and Dal. Okay? So it's not that complicated. You can, inshallah, the rest of you, those who are not here, you can read it and practice writing Dal and Dal in your book and some words also with that. We learned last time the words Dajaj. I just want to check the meaning that you remember.
Okay?
Check in. Very good. What is the meaning of khudud?
Blind
cheeks. Yes, khudud is, you can look at the book. Actually, we are on page number 77. Okay, so go on page number 77 and just look at the Arabic words. So the meanings will be fresh one more time.
Cheeks.
Yeah. What is that? Khudud. Khudud is cheeks. And the third one is khudud. What was the hudud?
Boundaries.
Boundaries or limits. Hudud ya hudud? Second or third?
Second.
Hudud cheeks. Yeah. Is the, remember that this is plural, jama. If it will be, you want to say only one singular, it will be khad. And similarly, hudud is plural and singular will be had. Now the fourth word is Jadid. Jadid means new. Yes.
Hudud means limit.
Yes. Hudud limits or boundaries. So Jadid means new. But remember that soon you will see the word Jadida with Ta Marbuta. That means also new. It's an adjective and it comes in agreement with the noun. Because we do not use the word Jadid by itself. There has to be a noun before Jadid. If you want to say new, so what do you mean by new car, new house, new clothes, right? New book. So it depends on the noun. If the noun is a masculine gender, then you say Jadid. If it's a noun is a feminine, then you will say Jadida. Yeah. For example, the word kitab, book, is masculine. And you want to say new book. So how do you say it? Kitab jadid. Also, one more thing. In Arabic, we do not bring adjective first. We bring noun first, then the adjective. It is just opposite of English. English we say new book. So we bring new first, then the book. In Arabic, kitab first, book first, and then new adjective. And it applies to all kinds of adjectives. No exception. However, if you want to say, Brother Noman, new car, how do you say in Arabic? Sayara jadida. Not jadid. Because the word sayara is feminine. It has tamarbuta.
Is that the same as Urdu?
The formation?
Formation of noun.
No. In Urdu, it's just like English. We say like nai kitab. So we say nai or new first. Then the noun kitab.
Sorsi is the opposite.
In Arabic is opposite. Or in Farsi, like Arabic, yes. Okay, next word is adab. What was the meaning of adab?
Manners.
One is manners, etiquette, literature. Yes.
Difference in spelling. Adab
No, both spellings are same. It depends on the context. So, where you are going to translate adab as manners or adab as a literature. For example, you say al adab ul amriki. It will be American literature. Okay, the word ahdas.
Event.
Dubab. Makhi. Flies. Do you remember that ayah in the Quran? وَإِنْ يَسْلُبْهُمُ الذُّبَابُ شَيْئًا لَا يَسْتَنْقِذُوهُ مِنْ دَعُفَ الطَّالِبُ وَالْمَطْلُوبُ. Beautiful expression by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. He says that look at those people who worship idols. Sometimes they put the sweets or other things, you know, around them. And if the flies, they are coming, so these idols, they are so much... they do not have any life or any strength. They cannot even remove those flies from them.
Helpless.
So then Allah said, "Da'ufa talibu wal matlub." The one who is asking from them, that the seeker of the help is also weak, and the object they are asking the help from them, that is also weak. Both of them, da'ufa talibu wal matlub. Okay, the second word is Zaat. Zaat means
self.
Third is Badara. Badara is verb. Sow the seed.
Sowing
the seed. But it's a past tense, so you will translate. He sowed the seed in the ground, in the soil. The fourth word is Khud. Khud means?
Take.
This is a word of command, and that is also in the Quran.
So many times it's come khud.
Yes. Ya Yahya khudil kitaba biquwa. Surah Maryam. Okay, next word is hadari. Hadari means?
Beware,
yes.
Caution.
And sixth is tadabdub. Is confusion, hesitation, dilemma, that is all meaning of tadabdub.
It's in Urdu also tadabdub.
Yeah, actually in Urdu also we should pronounce tadabdub. Yes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used another form from the same root, mudabdabin, regarding the hypocrite people, munafiqeen, that whom mudabdabin abayna dhalik. They are confused between kufr and iman. La ilaha ula, they are neither on this side, wa la ilaha ula, nor on the other side. Okay, so let's move to the next page, that is page number 80. What is 80? 80. So we have same words over here, you need to write them down for your practice in your book, and then three words with the letter dal. The first is dal, that means self. Then the second one is yadub. Yadub is verb from daba. It melts. Melts like ice. You know, if ice is melting and you want to say as a present tense that it's melting, then you say yadu. And the third one is akhadtu. Akhadtu. I too. It's the same root of khud. Khud is word of command, like if I say to you, take it. And akhadtu, I took, is a past tense for first person. We are going to learn very soon, inshallah, the conjugation. The conjugation is very important in Arabic. Okay, it's related to the verbs. Once you get the conjugation and the pattern of the conjugation, how to conjugate the verbs, mashallah, then you know Arabic.
How do you say I take?
I will take.
No, I take now. Right now.
Yeah, like present tense. Akhud. Akhud, naam. Akhud. So, this is akhadtu. Now, the next letter is ra. So, ra is simple, like R, we have the sound. And we had the words in Arabic with this letter, rabab. Rabab. It's a name also, and it's a name of a musical instrument. And also it comes for amusement, play, entertainment, for those meanings. Number two is rudud. Do you remember the meaning of rudud? Replies. Very good. Rudud. When you reply the email of someone, right? You reply a letter, so that's called rudud. And it's plural, jama. The wahid will be rad. Number three is kharaj. No. Taxation. Another meaning is growth. Yes. And fourth word is tabreer. Tabreer, justification. Justification. And next word is jar. Jar means neighbor. But male neighbor. So female, you add tamarbuta. And next word is wurud. Wurud means arrival. Very good. Okay, I also explained last time between dal and ra that dal should be above the line and ra should be below the line. Otherwise, sometimes people, they write both of these letters same. Okay, so you need to make the difference between dal and dal. Dal and ra. Okay. Then we have next letter is za. It is on next page. It's nain wa thamanin. Page number 82. And there is no big discussion about that. It says this consonant corresponds to the English sound z, as in zebra. So, whenever you see this letter za, pronounce just like z in English. And we have the words with this letter. What is the first word?
Zawj.
Husband. Yes. So, what's your guess for the wife? Very good. Tamarguta.
How would you say my husband?
Zawji.
So you just did it.
Yes. Okay. And how someone says my wife?
Zawja.
Zawjati. Not Anna.
No more Anna.
That would be I am my wife.
Yeah. Zaujati. Now, the next word is Ahzab. This is a surah in the Quran also, Surah Al-Ahzab.
Confederate.
No. There was a battle also, Ghazwa Ahzab. But what is the meaning of Ahzab? It's the plural of Hizb. Hizb means group. Party.
Alliance.
Alliance also, yes.
Our confederate.
Confederates. Yeah. Yes, there you go.
It's like Hizbullah is
Allah's group, yes.
I don't want to bring it up.
No, but you can refer it from the Quran because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala used the word Ulaika Hizbullah. Ala inna Hizballahi humul muflihun. This is the ending of Surah Al-Mujadalah in Juz 28. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says about the mu'min people, believing men and women, that they are the party of Allah. They are the group of Allah.
Allah is the party.
Okay, so next word is Zujaj. Any idea of the meaning Zujaj? It's a daily use word, you know, thing that we need almost every day. And it's related to eating and drinking. Most drinking. No, that is Dajaj. Is glass. Okay, any bottle, any cup, glass that we drink the water from, so the glass is called Zujaj. Okay, number four is Yazur. This is a verb, and the root of Yazur is Ziyara. You know the meaning of Ziyara.
Ziyara, yes.
Yes. Ziyara means visit. Yazur means he visits.
He visits.
Or he is visiting.
Can you put Dhamma on Yazur?
There is no need of Dhamma because we have vowel after that.
Okay.
So when the long vowel is there already, there is no need to put Dhamma. Yazur, he is visiting. Like if I say my father is visiting, right, at present, so Yazur Abi or Walid. This is the context. Okay, Jawaz.
Reason, logic.
That is more in Urdu, but in Arabic is permit. Permit.
Passport.
And but for the passport, we have to add the word safar.
Javaza.
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 Javaza,
okay,
what's the
word?
Permit.
Passport
is
written Javaza for Javaza Safar.
Yeah, Javaza Safar. Because passport is a travel permit. Right? So, Javaza Safar. Literal Javaz means any kind of permit. And the next word, sixth one is Tazeed. It's from Ziyada. To increase. More. So Tazeed is also a verb. It means it increases. It increases.
So there is it in Arabic?
No, when you translate in English. So, if you are referring to a non-human thing, then you will translate in English like it.
Okay.
But in Arabic, it should be hiya, she, and if it's a feminine noun, and tazid could be two meanings, either she or you, a man. So, it depends on the context. Okay. So, writing of za is also just like ra. And we had the first word is Zawj. So you practice writing at home, inshallah. And then the next word is Khubz. Khubz is bread. Yes.
That's easy.
Yeah. Whenever you go to any Middle Eastern store, you will see Arabic bread. Huh? And What do you see over there? Written Khubz Arabi.
Khubz Arabi.
Arabic.
Khubz.
Khubz.
Or is that a dialect?
Khubz, yes, is a dialect. Dialect, yes. In formal Arabic is sukoon on ba, khubz. You can see in the book also. But in the colloquial, khubuz.
So that in Surah Yusuf, then khubz.
Naam, khubzan.
What's the
plural? It is a kind of word that does not, there is no use of the plural. Khubz is like kind, you know. So for singular, plural, you say khubz.
So it's like in English.
Like in English.
Ha, bread, yes.
But
yes.
In Urdu you say roti and roti.
Roti, yeah, yes. Ha. In Urdu we make the jama,
yeah.
But not in English. I mean in Arabic or in English. Okay. However, the person who makes the bread, we have the word from the same root. Do you know what is the word in Arabic for baker who is baking the bread? Khabbaz. We write like that. Khabbaz. So the root of khabbaz is khubz. Baker. So it has become a profession now. Yeah, all those people who are working in the bakery and they are baking other things also. So the name of this profession is Khabbaz, or the person.
And what is bakery?
Makhbaz. Makhbaz, the place of baking, it's called makhbaz. Okay. So now we will move to the next page. Next page, how do you say in Arabic? Page, you know the word page. No. I'm not saying safa number, page number. I'm saying or asking next page. So what is page in Arabic? Safha, safha, right? Safha. Next is talia. Talia, the following page, okay? Safha talia. No, with ta tawila, ta and alif, ta, lam, ya, and then ta marbuta in the end, yes. Because the word safha is feminine, so that's why the adjective will be also with ta marbuta. Safha talia.
But with the same order, the noun and adjective, it should be the other way around.
No. This is the same formation in Arabic that you bring noun first. Okay, if one is a following page, so just turn it in Arabic. Page first and then the following. Yes.
Okay.
So, Mada Tanzurun. What do you see on next page? Mada Tanzurun. Tanzurun from Nadar. What are you seeing?
RB.
Okay, it's a drill.
Oh, yeah.
Drill in Arabic is tamreen. So, your answer in Arabic should be tamreen.
Tamreen.
Nahnu nanzur tamreen. We are seeing drill. Okay. Nanzur. Nanzur. Brother Sami, how do you say tamreen 9 in Arabic? Just say number 9 in Arabic. Naam, tamreen 9. So tamreen 9, letter connection. Okay. Ittisalul huruf. Letter is harf or huruf. And connection is ittisal. When you connect, it's called ittisal. Ittisalul huruf. So the direction is that connect the letters to form words, then listen to them and write in the short vowels you hear. Okay? So we want to do it now, this exercise. Start connecting the letters and then I will check. The only thing that you need to pay attention on connecting letters and non-connecting letters. You need to know that which letters are connecting and which are non-connecting. I should have candies. Anyone who will finish first, he will get a candy.
I finished.
You did?
No.
Very good. Probably you did at home?
I did Zal.
No, you are on above the line. Yes. Just make this shape little bit more
like Zay.
We will learn about Hamza when it comes in the end of the word. It should be down over here.
Like,
that's why I was telling about Dal and Ra.
I'm done.
Okay, everyone's done?
Yeah, I'm done.
Okay, very good. Mashallah. So, we have 14 words and I will give a chance to everyone, inshallah, to come down and show us how did you write. Okay? So, who wants to come for the first word? I. Tafaddal. Everyone wrote like that. If you can check your words, if there was any other way you wrote, so correct yourself. So the main thing is that letter Ra, the first letter is non-connecting,
yes.
Should not be connected with Zal, and Zal also is not connecting, so do not connect with Alif. Right? Very good. Okay, for the next word. आप आ रहे हैं क्या? आओ, आओ। पहले अपना वर्ड लिख दीजिए। सेकंड वर्ड। नीचे लिख दीजिए इसके नीचे।
Arabic.
Very good. खुद अपना मार्क कर लीजिए. एवरी वन रोड लाइक दैट खादिर. सो द लेटर खा इज कनेक्टिंग, इज कनेक्टेड विद अलिफ बट नॉट दाल एंड रा. नाउ थर्ड वर्ड
इज देयर टू राइट द
आंसर.
Yes. Very good.
Jack is yellow.
Yes. In Urdu, not in Arabic. In Arabic is armor. Those army people, they use it armor. That's called zarf.
So this is over the line, though. This is supposed to be below the line.
Ha, he draw the line, but it should be like that. Like your line should be here and.
And then
like, it should be 10% letter above the line, 90% below the line, like that. But dal will be there. Okay, next. So what is the main point? Because we are connecting the letters, all three, they were non-connecting. Very good. Perfect. So ha is connecting, is connected with ra, but vau is non-connecting. That's why vau is separate by separate.
So vau is supposed to go below the line as well?
Yes. Some part of vau above the line and then the rest of below the line. Next word is? The next word is raja.
Hamza is separate or is on alif?
No, Hamza is separate, and we learned in the description of Hamza, and I was explaining to him also. If you go back and look at the Hamza, whenever Hamza will come in the end of the word, it should be down as a final letter, and it should not be on the top of alif. Okay, Raja. Yes, Raja means hope. Hope. Yeah. He's enjoying. You connected well, but Arabic style in the words Bahar or Bihar, either this way, so it will be print version, and handwritten version will be like that.
Yeah, I also wrote it like that.
Yes.
It's Urdu style, I think.
This is Urdu style, yes. Okay. Bahar, if you can read in two ways. Bahar, the person who is sailing the boat, sailor. Sailor, that's called Bahar. Okay. And if you read it Bihar, with the kasra on ba, it means the plural of bahar. That means oceans. Yes, brother Umar, ready?
Yeah.
Ta'al hina. And brother Harun, get ready after him.
Inshallah.
Next word is
Bihar, right?
Noun.
Azwaj.
Azwaj. Yes.
And you can put Hamza on the top.
Yes. Azwaj. So see how many letters, all of them, they are like non-connecting. Yes. Alif except Jabba. It's a final letter and alif is non-connecting, so it will be separate. So what is your guess about the meaning azwaj?
Wife.
Husband.
Husband.
Husband. It's the jama of zauj.
Okay.
Not zauja.
Okay, okay.
That Jama of Zawja will be different.
Yeah.
It's husband.
Husband, yes.
Husband.
And Azwaj also in the context of spouse's husband, but if you are using for everything human, non-human, that you will translate as pairs. Pairs. As Allah said in Surah Yasin, Subhanalladhi khalaqal azwaja kullaha. Glorified is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who created the things in pairs. Mm-hmm. Everything has a pair. Sometimes we do not realize, but every, you know, animals, trees, plants, everything has the pair. Okay, then
so
next word.
So plural for the wives or the wife, wives
will be zaujat.
Zaujat. So how? So because the
Israel
asked is that there's a word azwaj mutahara. So the wives of the prophet, right?
Right.
So how do you say that in that? Because
over there it will be literal meaning of zauj, like pair, like life partner.
Okay.
So in that meaning.
Okay.
Brother Harun?
Sure.
Next. Next word. And yeah, you can make dal like this shape. You can make that one also with that shape. Yes.
In the print version. The print version is good.
No. Actually, ha is in the.